Hello.
What I didn't realize was that Dan had the slick gear speed on his gears, which he probably didn't configure himself. But mine was on the hard gear. And also,
I don't even know what that means.
The slick gears is when you can pedal. You don't have so much resistance, so you can pedal. Like, if you see how fast your legs are going around compared to mine, yeah, mine had the most resistance. Yours had the least resistance.
But once you get going, it's much easier for you.
Once I get going, yeah, I can.
Because once you start to get tired on the other
one, I can maintain
a
faster speed.
Gonna get going fast again.
Well, you have less resistance though, so it can help in one way.
I think you're just trying. I think this is like a very awful display of excuse making.
Also,
right after the fact, you know, don't think this goes down very well. Just saying.
Also, I immediately almost ran and drove off the track.
Yeah,
which did not help.
Those things are really hard to steer actually, because you've got the two wheels in the back and all that weight in the back, and you can't lean at all as you normally would have with a bike.
Yeah.
So what happens is if you turn as much as you want would normally turn with a bike, and it just goes like this. It just like starts. It just goes into like a sheer right kind of angle on the drive there, and it's just you just go into the pond.
Yeah, those rickshaws.
It took me a while to learn how to drive straight with it. That took me. I had to like figure that out, how to drive straight.
Yeah, yeah.
I couldn't go straight.
It's so weird riding them. It's super weird. So Dan is officially 1-0 up in the challenge. There are more challenges to come. I think there's another one coming, going to be aired in a few days. But if you missed that, it will be on a YouTube later. Look up ECS League on YouTube, and you'll see it on there. So GT versus is a godsend on train. The knife is happening as we speak. They are itching and raring to go. We will soon find out if Godsent can take both their own pick as well as G2's. They took Overpass over G2, which was G2's pick. And now we find ourselves on train.
I think it's a great map actually for both teams. I think, as you said previously, it's, you know, it's Godsent's choice. Obviously, they feel comfortable with this one. But at the same time, G2 are a great train team. One of the reasons, I think, is because it's one of the best maps for, like, if you're just like a really good engine. If you have a good engine behind your trades and your tactics, and that G2 are a team like that. You can keep it simple and just play the trades. You can get into the A yard. You get into the B bomb site. It's like quite easy to get the entrance. If you look at Overpass, it's much more difficult. If you want to go to A on Overpass, look. We saw all the aggression. We saw all the mix-ups that Godsent were throwing at G2, making their lives difficult. G2 will not have to deal with that on the T side for this map. So it allows them to get into the spots where they really are going to be able to flourish. And speaking of which, we are going to be jumping into the pistol round, and immediately G2 will be on the CT side as you can all see. Don't know why I said one there.
Shox and Screamer playing very close to connector for the fast rotation, if necessary, or maybe a double peek in certain angles. Shox made his way to main now, only good for one kill though, and it's advantage Godsent. JW just running almost blind, body and Scream. Last two for the CTs. What is going on there? Oh my god, that is ridiculous. How many tours up to that, AJW? Body, last one. Schneider on the train. This is looking unlikely for Body. You know where he is? He has no Kevlar either, so these body shots will hurt a lot. Trying to bait out the player, and it's JW, of course. So he needs no bait. He wants to have a look. Body has a kit. Got 12 bullets in the magazine. Schneider repositioning, and he's not expecting the backstab. At least this time it wasn't an actual stab.
Yeah, that's kind of cool too for JW, because you can see he's on $5,500 now. I doubt he's going to get the AWP out straight away, but he could, and he's going to want to get the AWP pretty quickly. JW, I feel like if you're ever in a position like this with JW, JW's going to win. He's going to, whatever shenanigans are going on, he is like the master of shenanigans. He is King Shenanigans, is JW. So that is going to be a nice extra amount of money for him to play with. You can see he's picked up the AK, so we won't see an AWP from him, and I'd like that in this round. I don't think you need one. I think it's an edge. It's not going to give you an edge, really. It's just potential risk. And Godsent will clean up a couple of players. A bit of aggression caught by the Godsent side from G2, and Godsent will now be planting the bomb, which is going to force G2 to move out of any sneaky positions and force confrontation.
The meat shots! Oh, it could have been life-changing. But they weren't. Smiths with the Deagle has not much to offer, not much to save. Gotta respect the jumping. I still don't use mouse wheel to jump. I just can't do it. I'm too.
I heard even with mouse wheel, like the consistency can only be like 50%. It's a 50% chance that you'll actually manage to nail it.
I'm a spacebar kind of guy. Maybe one day.
I think that was through Pronax's legs into JJW's head. That shot. Yeah, I'm spending
a lot of money to kill a deagle.
I'm spacebar as well. Always been spacebar. The thing is, as well, I want to have as little as possible on my mouse. For example, I know a lot of people would put, let's say, you know, buttons for, you know, weapon switches and so on their mouse. But I feel like my mouse should be doing nothing else other than aiming. And I feel like there's even an argument. And in fact, actually, the best aimer ever from Quake 3 and Quake 4 was a guy called Toxic. And he didn't, like, his mouse, he didn't shoot with his mouse. He shot with his some key on the keyboard, leaving his mouse completely free of any pressure at all. And he can just aim with his mouse exclusively.
That's pretty interesting.
Yeah, he was the best aimer as well. So you have to imagine, maybe there's something to it. Maybe there's not.
I've never even thought to do that. You could do that with, like, the shift key, for example.
Yeah.
Or maybe something else if you're going for taps. I don't know, shift might be a bit weird. The little pinky. I don't have one finger that's pink, to be honest with you. They're all the same color, so. The knife. Oh, Scream. Looking for revenge, but none afforded to him.
I respect the attempt there. That was pretty bold.
Why not?
It's a really good play, I think. It's a really good play.
Yeah, he's got nothing to lose there, so.
Yeah. If he gets the knife kill, the money's going to be so, so good.
Literally nothing to lose. You could throw your USP away. You'll spawn with a new one in the next round. There we go. A good start for Godsent on their favoured map. Now Flusher, well, never mind. I was going to say Flusher could drop an AWP. Or he could just AWP himself. But then he doesn't really need to drop one. There are people with more money, so they'll just continue. They'll be patient for now. They know the AWP is coming onto Smith. If they want one, they can take his, should they win a round. But will they be allowed to? G2 are limited in their utility. Does that mean aggression? They're not playing close to main at the moment. Shox is moving towards the Pop Dog. Godsent got Flusher and Crims towards B. I do wonder. It's not often you see, I think the generally accepted default from a CT side is to have one person in B. But we don't see any fast plays from into B at the moment. But perhaps people don't want to be up against a 4-4 CT side on a retake. In that situation, I don't know, but I do wonder if we'll end up there. People just trying to break the timing and force the CT side to guess where to put the second man early on. Weaken defenses elsewhere. JW slowly creeping up Ivy. RPK holding a passive angle. He's got Smith's reasonably close by, should anything go terribly wrong. But again, Smith is holding angles. Flusher eliminated towards B. Trying to go for the fake, it seems. Crim's coming out of Pop Dog. Smith is ready and waiting.
Yeah, I think it's a really big tell, isn't it, when you see that one guy go in deep by himself on B. But yeah, I can push now. And they can't even break the bomb site. So from every single conceivable front, that round failed for Godsent. But that's okay because they have another buy in store for G2. However, it's a bit unfortunate for Flusher. He doesn't have any cash, so somebody will have to drop him. Which I'm not sure who it was, but the money's more or less evening out at this point. So G2 are in a great position now to lock things down. Ooh, Scream. Why does he have 39 health already? Did someone shoot him in the back of the head? I think a teammate must have shot him in the back of the head, James.
That's a weird one. I don't...
Must be. It was so early on.
I mean, maybe he's been... Well, he's lost eight armor as well. I don't know. It's hard to say. It's possible he was knifed, but it's not. I don't know. Two plays left though for Godsent, so it may not matter. They're far away from the bomb. JW coming in from Ivy. See, Schneider's been spotted.
Yeah, there it was. Yeah, it was Shox. At least he gets a kill back onto Schneider. At least there is revenge. But this round can be lost. It can be lost for G2. JW has an AK. This year, I feel like he's gotten so much better with the AK as well. as opposed to 2015?
Yeah, I made a highlight video of JW using his grenade dirt to spray somebody down at CT on Mirage on A.
No. Wasn't that an AWP play?
No, no, it was a spray. It was a spray of an M4.
Oh, the
person Fox was on the other side. Yeah, Fox. Yeah. It was Fox.
Yeah, that was one of the most, like, you're just in the Matrix kind of play. Like, this would be a good idea, but, like, it's like something you've never done before. It just, like, appears in your brain, you just do it. You're like, whoa, I'm really smart. That was amazing, amazing stuff.
Godsent on the pistols, looking likely to lose their lead. Smoke could have flashed onto Pronak, so perhaps a bomb plant is the plan here. Not far beyond Glocks in this round, the T side. JW again, expecting nobody to be watching the smoke, but on this occasion they are. Maybe preying on the idea that there's a threat of Godsent going for a rush elsewhere, and he can't pull anything away. So maybe if JW gets a kill there, maybe the B bomb site ends up weaker sometimes. Hasn't worked out on this occasion though, but again, Godsent didn't invest too much into this particular round. And now Schneider just holding angles with the time he has, waiting for somebody to peek, trying to do as much damage as possible, be as efficient as possible with the purchase of this Deagle.
No planterization of the Bombzors for Godsent in this round, and momentum has struck perhaps a G2 if they can get this one. They seem really strong all of a sudden, just, you know, really holding it down. And it's one of the reasons, again, why I feel like this is always going to be a strong G2 map. They don't have to, there's nothing that's really all that complicated. You just have to, you know, you can just hold your positions. As far as the rotation goes, Godsent can't really force too much in the way of rotation. You just hold your positions, hold your setups, you adjust if you lose a man, and then you just frag. Fragging is something that G2 can do very well, and we already see the first frag made. RPK picks up a kill, and that is going to send Godsent into a bit of a poor position. You can see Schneider is going to reinforce the push here towards B. And that's where Godsent will put all their last efforts.
Perfectly timed flashbang from the CT side. We've got four Ts above the sights. They've got smokes to get the usual shenanigans done. Minutes on the clock, and they're not going to feel pressure to do something right now. Body is on the site, looking towards connector. But they've got a player there. Ah, I think he's looking towards the corner of the train, just in case somebody had passed that smoke, maybe. Godsent going back now. Three smokes, and this time they're going to deploy. Flashbang as well. Body on the off angle. Shock's holding the high ground, one would presume. Spraylight coming in. Second player will get there. Indeed, Shox takes the hider player down. Can the bomb be... Oh, the bomb's been left behind! The bomb's on the high ground!
Terrible mistake has been made. And, this means Schneider has to basically just kill everyone. But it's just not going to happen. G2 close down the round. And you can always allow for those mistakes in the chaos. But, that's going to put Godsent in a pretty awful position. Because now G2, they've labored through the really difficult rounds. And they've found themselves with now the Eco Godsent that they should be able to pick up for the 5-3, and presumably you don't expect Godsent to do too much damage here. So this is where G2 find that stability, and Godsent are going to have to really fight. They've lost that edge of that pistol round victory now, well and truly. You have a scout on Schneider though, and a lot of deagles, so you never want to count a team out like Godsent with all that equipment. Nothing just yet though. Mr. Schneider, what do you have for us? What do you have for us? Oh, looks like he spots somebody, and he himself has been spotted. There's blood on the train, James. It's a bloody train.
Yep. So, Shock's repositioning towards B. He's holding the high ground again, but this time it's with the second AWP on the side. Maybe looking to get a deeper angle. He was over towards connector, but indeed, this will give him earlier warning. This is an eco from Godsent, so if he can get a second shot off, that's going to be fantastic for him. Off angles being held again by RPK. He's been in this spot more than once in this round, this half, this map. That's what I meant to say. Look at the timing there. Unbelievable stuff. J Goss as JW starts to look away. That's going to activate the players towards B once again. Shox gets taken down by the scout somehow. In the meantime, Body tries to slow people down. It's Flusher alone now. 20 seconds, the bomb's on the floor. He needs to cross to the site. But maybe Smiths will make things a little bit easier for him if he continues to push. Scream will get the tagging done. G2 survive with three players. Don't have time to rescue the second AWP, unfortunately. So they will have to splash the cash if they want to continue in that direction. And indeed they will. RPK at 7,700. He'll drop the AWP for Shox. No, yeah, 10K actually. Lovely.
So I would assume we would see something faster on the A yard now, because we haven't seen that from Godston just yet, where they have a lot of smokes, they prey upon the chaos, they try to cause a huge amount of distraction. Although they're going to go for the rush in alley, just running in non-stop until they find RPK and take him down. Smith's on top of the train there, nice kill, but it looks like the trades come in. G2 are all over it. They easily pick up this this aggression. Flusher has to clutch, but he won't be able to do so against G2. They have, again, some of the strongest individuals in the business, and they are going to easily hold that. And I'm surprised Godston went with the alley play as opposed to the yard play. But so perhaps they have a read that G2 play quite deep on the yard, which would mean that they would only have to kill one person, and then they would get in very easily. But that could be one of the reasons for that choice. Looking really good for G2 though right now. They're looking super strong.
Yeah, they look good for a strong CT half at the moment. That said, it can flip around relatively easily. Body and Shox have 7K-ish each. Other than that, the money is low. So if Godston win two rounds in a row, they can break G2 and turn this score upside down. Easier said than done, however. JW rotating away from the IV position at the moment. Body and Shox in a familiar position. Scream playing deep from connector. So, Scream's on the... Oh, sorry, he's in the high ground. Excuse me. RPK is looking towards pop. Body's in for some trouble here. Flusher gets on the angle first. That is a favorable angle for Flusher in that situation. Similar to the Inferno apps. The execute comes in to beat. Molotov is down on the site to try and slow the plant, but Godston are focusing on taking the entire train yard.
Yeah, it's looking pretty good so far. They are pushing really far up. However, we get a great stop here from Shox and Scream together through smoke with the AWP. Godston really having trouble getting the last stretch one, but Crims comes into play finally, gets himself a very important double kill. RPK is forced to go back for the frag, takes critical damage in the process, leaving him up against Flusher. Both players incredibly low, and no grenades for either one to really use. There's a flashbang for RPK, but is he going to just grab the AWP and go? It looks like he might do that. Or is he going to go for a new approach? That is genius, James. That is absolute genius. But he will not leave himself with enough time to defuse the bomb. At least he got the kill, though. Will he survive? 5 HP. Ooh, there we go.
Nicely done. Last frag, AWP. Got the best he could out of it. Yeah, this angle, I believe the person whose enemy is coming on his... Oh, never mind. It's hard to explain concisely. 4-6. JW on the UMP. Not a stranger to the less selected guns in this game. G2 continue with the double AWPs, and that is why I said this would be a strong map for G2 as well as Godsent, being Godsent pick train, because the Smith Shox AWP possibilities are quite serious. Body's shown himself to be a good fifth for G2 as well. So JW's managed to get very deep very quickly. RPK is here on his own. And again, JW's just constantly being a nuisance towards Ivy while action happens elsewhere. Scream going down may force RPK to... Oh no, he hasn't checked properly. Finally goes back. Just about finishes the kill despite getting dinked. Opportunities for Godsent though. Opportunities for both. High ground will be RPK's death. That's a nice snap from Pronax as well. So now it's Shox alone. Trying a very difficult map to come back from. Schneider's going to pop out, but he hasn't got much health. Instant trade. Crims doing the job. 5-6. Godsent could buy, and they will.
Yeah, they're managing to battle back at the key moments here to make this competitive. And with this this chaos in the yard, it's something that can go either way with so much skill on both teams. So that's kind of would be something that would be great to see more of from Godsent. Just bring it down to a 3-versus-3 sort of type situation. If you can kind of do that consistently and you're out in the yard, it's really interesting. It gives them a lot of opportunities here. Otherwise, it seems like it's very difficult for them to get that opening pick to get into bomb sites. And now they just have to deal with an eco. How hard could that be? How hard could that be? So far, so good. Double smoke. Perhaps that was not intended, but it's fine. They got plenty of smokes anyway. Who cares? Do you care, James?
No. So I said they had to break two buys from the CT side, and they've done that. Now the question is, can they turn the spot upside down? Can they make it a 9-6? Or will G2 recover? Players are being lost for Godsent. Bodies alone, but are there guns for him to collect? He's got Mac 10. I'm sure he would like something better than that. Again, he is proving to be quite adept with the headshots as well. The reload will give his position away to JW, who is, of course, going to at least bait him. Very cheeky from JW. Mac 10 versus an AK. I hope he doesn't feel compelled to push in a situation, but then again, it is JW.
Yeah, there is absolutely no reason why you'd want to risk dying to Mr. Mac 10.
Unless you are JW. there we go, look. But the thing is, I won't even criticize him for it because it's just him. It is who he is. He's a big fan of W. And it brings us some very entertaining highlights indeed, so by all means. And again, he's allowed to do what he wants, even if it doesn't make sense. Because that leaves your player with confidence as opposed to doubt, whether it works or not. So thinking the long term, it's profitable for Godsent to allow him to be him. He's a maniac with a license to be a maniac. Shox, will he be ready for RPK? JW, sorry.
I mean, he must realize, you know, the timings, his respawn with respective to what the CTs could possibly do. So he's got a, I'm sure he'll have something in the back of his mind thinking there could be a guy in RPK's position.
There we go.
Boom. It is too easy, isn't it? Everyone's dead. All of them. Apart from Scream and Smiths.
9-6 looks possible. It looks possible, Dan. Scream and Smiths very close together. Oh, Schneider spots the hip. But it's not time to dance for him. And that is opportunity for G2 because Scream didn't take much damage in that exchange. There's a man disadvantage, but they're going to go the conservative route and try to close out the last two rounds, picking up two orbs. I think Scream's carrying a... Was it an AK or something? Carrying something away. But he's holding an angle, which Flusher might peek soon if he goes towards long. Ooh, Flusher going for the high ground peek instead. Okay, he's checking everything meticulously. Oh man, he's lining up on a flashbang as well. Here it comes. Boom! Ooh, I thought somebody died there, but he didn't. But great attention to detail. So Scream will get taken down. One AWP saved for G2. Flash is so smart, man. He's so smart.
Yeah, he's one of the smartest players, I think. He's a player as well that has such a good mindset in how, you know, he approaches situations. He views his skill so much more than just, you know, pointing and clicking at people. Like, you know, positionally, if he's got grenades, you know, how can he outthink the opponent? He uses every facet of Counter-Strike to better the other man. And Godsent are up against some pistols. It's a little bit scary to begin with, but it looks like it's going to be cleaned up pretty swiftly here. And G2... won't really be left for too much. I mean, you can see Smith was at the back there with the AWP. Hopefully, you know, he was able to maybe trade being at the back. All the pistol players can prevent the T's from getting to him. He can easily fire off shots, but it just never quite worked out like that as Godsent thought better of it after getting the initial kills. And Godsent will go to 8 rounds.
I think the cool thing about JW as well is that Flusher, is that he's really smart in a way that's easy to understand. For the average viewer.
Yeah, it's like Neo as well. I feel like Neo is another player. You can look at him and be like, he is making a lot of very correct plays.
Will Smiths be able to save? That is a question. Last round coming up of the first half. 2W loses a bit, but they're not shy of money here in this situation. Godsent. So after a shaky start versus G2, G2 winning 6 rounds in a row, Godsent have answered straight back. Can they take the last one? G2 again on 2 AWPs. Maybe that's what the 2 stands for. Shock's going to the connector position. CTs get faster to that than the Ts do to T main. Smith's not going too deep on the angle. JW continues to be a nuisance for RPK. Could get 2 here. He's going to settle on that. Again, that's going to stretch the defenses. Maybe limit how deep G2 can go. Now there's a pick over towards the B bomb site, but have they seen the bomb? They haven't. They have no idea where the bomb is. JW forcing the aggression once again towards Ivy. Now 2 kills coming back the way of G2. Shox gets taken down, but surely they realize that it is the B bomb site. Smith rotating, but Scream is popping faces.
I love how we just hear the dink. Just dink, dink. That is the Scream for you, isn't it? Schneider, this is a scary position to be in. All the smoke will go away. Will we see a flick? Oh no. Jumps up just at the worst possible timing. As the smoke is gone, and he is fully visible. And the round will be won by G2, and that's pretty impressive. It was, again, just a lot of these rounds are really chaotic. Really chaotic. And you can see that, Pronax is having to make a lot of calls here. Let's go over here. Oh, wait. Okay, we've got to go over here now, because the situations just keep changing so rapidly. And you can see Scream getting those important entries there. But now we move on to the CT side, for God's sake. And is this, will they be stronger here? Would you expect?
It's hard to say. I don't have an answer to your question.
I feel like G2, I always feel like G2 are a stronger T side, but I feel like it's pretty hard to predict on train. I think for some of the reasons why they're a stronger T side, it's on train, it helps them, their CT side as well. Oh. How's body untouched, James? How is he untouched right now?
Hard body.
Impressive. There we go. There we go. Godsent finally striking back, and they have dropped the bomb as well. But they are dropping players at the same time. And now it's just Flusher.
Flusher with 1:10 on the clock of his opponents. As the first one picks up a kit as well. RPK taking a lot of damage. Both Smiths and RPK are quite heavily tagged, rotating the bomb towards the B bomb site. RPK has options. And he's going to place. Ooh, they've kind of planted it for connector. RPK on the high ground. And Flush is going to take a different approach. That kit affords him some precious few seconds. RPK and Smiths deep towards the CT side of the bomb site. They're expecting Flusher to come in from CT. Will he go high or will he go low? Many angles for Flusher to check. Ooh, it's a bullet from Smiths. And the bullet from RPK will be the last bullet of the round. 8-8. G2 can take the lead again.
I like how he goes pop dog there, because I think one of the biggest problems you have is if they go for that kind of default plant and then they start playing from the high positions, I think then it gets really... really awkward. So by just taking that position, you can either catch them moving there or you at least have a way to engage those positions. So it's pretty nice right there for Flusher, but he will not get the frags in the end, and G2 will get themselves again these rounds where they just love the SMGs. They are loving the SMGs here against these 4 spies.
Yeah, that moving accuracy going to be good in tight corners on train as well. I think it's the MP9 which has what I would call, well, it has the best jumping accuracy of the MP9s. So if you're jumping around corners and such, then maybe that's going to give you an edge here or there. But it's the T side with the SMGs rather than the CTs. No MP9 for them. I still miss the TMP on FY Ice World. It's the best combo ever.
It had a really satisfying sound because it's like such a high rate of fire and it's silenced. I don't know, it's kind of satisfying to use. I'm not sure why. Although it was incredibly ineffective. It was terrible. It was incredibly terrible.
B but rush on Dust. Dust 2. Rush double doors.
I don't know, man.
Rush double doors up into B apps. You could kill three people with a TMP.
I don't know.
Well, I could anyway. Don't know about you, mate.
Well, I don't know who you're playing against. Bots, maybe.
I was unstoppable with a TMP. Bots were useless in those games. All they did is follow waypoints. Just a waste of time. Schneider looking. Oh, opting against it. Going back again. Deep. HE. Close, but not quite. G2 have missiles to look out for. Here's another one. That one is going to hit the spot. Scream has lost half his life. And the nades continue. We're going to see a push here from Godsent. They're isolating players, however. They may not expect how many players are in there. All the players are delivering. JW.
Ooh, that lineup was glorious. Imagine if he had something a bit more suitable for that position. The spray down would have been real.
Yeah, just not the right weapon.
Even with a 5-7 potentially, would be probably better there. But alas, it was not to be. Flusher could still get an extra kill here. These players are pretty low, but he will be finished off pretty handily by G2. So a little bit scary for a while, but in the end, things normalize, and we are in a pretty even game going into the second half of the last map between these two teams. We have the buy coming in from Godsent, but it will not feature an AWP. They're a little bit poor due to their starts on the second half, and as such, I wonder, you know, what kind of strategies they'll play as far as the initial opening setups go, because you have to be worried about Smiths. You've got to be worried about where he's going to try to pick you from. You can't really openly take angles in a lot of spots in the yard because of Smith's position, Smith having an AWP.
Will there be a peek? Oh, that one was close. Flusher alone in B for the moment, playing in the middle of the site. RPK's in May's way into pop. Scream, where is he? He is in the main area. So G2 could be setting up for some aggression or presence towards the A site. See Body deploying grenades for his teammate, support for the rifler, and Body's going to start to move up. If there's any traces, if there are any traces from these CTs, they may be in trouble. Ooh, Body's going to take them by surprise. Is he expecting the crossfire though? He's ready for it. JW goes down, looking for more on the site now, and the charge may come in from the CTs here. Again, Body with the headshots. Man advantage for the T's. Smith's still in Ivy. Pranex is around the smoke there as well. Schneider and Flush are trying to hold things down on the A site, but they can't. Down goes Schneider. Flush up, retreating. Pranex doing so quietly as well. So G2 have broken the CTs in this round. Who have no money in the bank.
Yeah, they're starting to build a nice lead in that sense. Godsent, they will, after the next save, be able to bring out the AWP. It might significantly change things for them. JW's been pretty good so far in this in the last couple of maps with the AWP. And that might be the change they need here, especially so that they can just get a bit more aggressive. I think just not having the AWP makes it much harder for them to feel confident taking certain angles. And can they even keep these M4s alive? It'd be really nice to keep those alive just to be able to pressure their opponents into the next round. And we'll see whether or not that's going to be the case here. Only one weapon surviving. Did he die to the bomb? I think he did. That sucks.
Ding. I like the ding sometimes when the bomb goes off. But I don't understand why there's a ding.
Or something, I guess. There's a collision with an object in the map, I guess, that makes a ding sound. Probably, maybe it's inside of a train. Maybe there's a bell inside of a train.
You know, when this map first came out, I was very taken by all the trains near T-spawn. I'm not a train person. My girlfriend keeps trolling me because I'm obsessed with air miles. She asks me if I spot planes. Shox is surely going to go down. Ooh, Flusher with the Deeg, no less. But even if that's an empty-ish B bomb site for G2 to capitalize on, they've got three players towards Ivy. They are not in a position to capitalize on anything apart from Scream's one-taps. JW, how has he got into this position? JW is about to ruin Cools. Screams running down Ivy while this action's happening from Pronax on the site. JW's moving towards main now. And the bomb's on the other side, but Scream's the last man standing. And it's about damage. His second kill, he's looking for the ace. Schneider slowly emerging on the high ground. Will Scream be ready for it? Hasn't spotted him just yet. Maybe not on the radar. There he is again. It's close, but not close enough. JW was flanking in the meantime towards Ivy. AWP stolen, as well as some other toys, some goods, some wares. Bosh.
It's so funny as well, because and some people will probably be like, oh, you know, why couldn't Scream see that guy? Because Snyder kind of peaked that spot quite a few times and he was visible on Scream's screen, but sometimes when you're really focused on certain angles, your brain just doesn't allow you to see stuff on your peripheral, because you're just super focused on anticipating the angle that you expect the most. So sometimes it's very difficult. Oh, that is glorious. Max 7 gets some action there from JW, causing problems. And he's going to emerge there, but Shox is going to cause some problems of his own, leaving just two players after the madness. After the dust settles a little bit, we have Crims and Flusher versus 3 in the bomb down on the A side. A grim tale, to say the least, here for Godsent.
Molotov is too late to capitalize on, to stop the bomb from going down. Crimson Flusher. It will run destruction though. Allow Flusher to move in. It may perceive both plays to be in connector, but there's just a one. Now Crims can emerge because Smith can no longer hold the angle. Shocks over towards Pop. Body on the other side of the train yard. Molly on the bomb will slow down any defuse attempt. Up on ladder, smart stuff. Out of sight for Flusher, and he's going to have to run back, but he can't make it. High ground works out for Body. Another round in the bag for G2. Are they going to win each other's maps? That's the first round Godsent have won on their CT side, and they've immediately been reset.
Yeah, G2 doing a really wonderful job. What an important round to win. And Godsent back to losing ways. Just pistols again. They've not really had too much success here. It can be hard on this map. And this is great for G2. Just a really fast yard take. Don't put anything to chance. There are a lot of horrible positions. Look at the Molotov placement. It's beautiful here. Just to deny all these scary positions from the CTs. And that's a nice fadeaway shot from Flusher, but G2's money is really very good. And I mean, right now they just need rounds. They need rounds or significant damage or stealing a gun away. These are the things that they need. Can somehow Pronax and Flusher do something else in this round? It'd be so difficult to get anything else out of this. Oh, wow. Pronax gets great damage and Flusher takes down another player. What is this happening right now? Flusher still has all the health, but Scream will end the dream with a bullet to the head.
Aim punch was too much for Pronax. Couldn't get his crosshair in the right place, unfortunately for him. Three rounds away are G2 from taking the pick of Godsent. But they're back on a bye, are Godsent. But JW is not back with some Kevlar. He's naked with his AWP. Miss on Yorp as well. It's all about who is faster. JW looking to peek main. And we can see Scream standing on the woods. That may help him look over the smoke, but also makes it more likely for him to get legged. Smith's going for it. Oh, JW shutting down the IV position, and that's why you see players run boosting past that angle.
It's kind of the straight re-peak there for the trade is very, very bold against JW. It's a hard situation. This time JW's able to come out on top. And just the lack of orbs that they've had, because their economy's always been terrible, you can really see how effective JW could possibly be at times when he has it in his hands, but it's just not enough on the CT side so far. Definitely possible here for Godsent to fight their way back. And in this round, they're 5 versus 3. They really feel the presence on to B. They've got to know at this point the rotation should surely start to ensue here for Godsent. They have all the frags as well. Scream has a huge amount of work on his hands. There's one, there's three more, and the bomb ticks. That goes in his favor at least.
Snyder pushing the smoke into the flames. That's not going to work out for him. Out comes Pronax, and he will be the hero of the hour. So Godsent not out of this one just yet. The T-Money, though, they've got a bomb down as well, and they're going to be straight back on the buy. RPK with $8,300 in the bank and drop for body. So pressure coming the way of Godsent. But this was a really good start. JW ready for the second shot, as well as the first. Already has crosshair high, expecting a player to be on the green box. Again, a standard start from Godsent. Only flusher towards B. Shox moving very quickly into the A side. But what can he do with it? Schneider's close. Maybe they have a... Maybe they saw him move out. Or the Tech 9 doing the job there. Body jammed. And he is going to be annihilated. Blown into smithereens. But Screams picks up an AK. Well, he's picking up some heads with his AK. JW, Tracer Fire is going to take him out. Pronax, my brain is melting down.
Well, it's going to be another reset. I mean, I don't know what Godsent are going to do now. I mean, it's just, it just keeps happening. They're just not at a point in the match where they can afford to allow this to occur, and G2 have every opportunity to take it over the line. It's a nice hunt for JW right at the end to take out the AWP. It will not be a factor in this round. They are so poor. And this is so limited. Your options, it's just such a desperate situation for Godsent to be in. And G2 know it. They've got the MAC-10 on Shox. That is going to be really nice here for Shox to be able to lead the charge somewhere, gain some information. He is going to be helping out in the secret push there. Maybe he'll just go down straight into B by himself, just get the information. If he can get an easy kill, he can lock down the forward choke point. There's a lot that Shox can do with that MAC-10. He's going to go for it. Shox in there. Oh, gets taken down by Flusher, though.
Three pistols left for Godsent. Make that two. G2 moving towards match point. And there's little that Godsent can do about it in this situation. The bomb thrown into the middle of the site to be collected to allow RPK to hold down the pop dog. But they know where Flusher is now. Minute 10, bomb not down. And Flusher has time to rotate. Not sure if they hear him from that position. What is he opting to do? Smith is in CT spawn, so... I'm not sure if he hears Flusher. He does now, and there it is. Match point for G2. Let's see what kind of buy Godsent can muster for this round.
Well, I guess it could be worse. I mean, the Mag 7, yeah, that's usable. We've got M4s, we've got FAMAS, CZ. I think, I mean, this is flush from the CZ as well, so it's basically a rifle. So it doesn't look too bad, all things considered. But, I mean, what kind of round did G2 want to throw at them? Honestly, they've had so much that's been working for them, and they're so good on the trays, they're so good in the open yard, they're just going to go and take it. Look at Shox moving forwards here towards core position. Easy frag on the Pronax, just knows exactly where to look. And GW, he's got awful engagements here with the Mag 7, has to get out of there, and another bomb site has been secured by G2. In the midst of the madness, the bomb site has been planted upon.
Godsent in a pretty bad spot now. Smith has a Molotov. There is a smoke onto Schneider, though, but there's no kit. So even if they manage to extinguish it, they're going to be subject to a lot of spray if it comes down to that. All the T's on the high ground now. Down goes Crims. So it's Schneider alone. Spot Smith having a look. Goes for the taps, but he can't do it. He can't do it. 16 to 10. G2 get revenge on Godsent, taking each other's maps in those two matches. Really nice stuff from the French-speaking side.
Yeah, I really feel like it's so scary with G2 in that open train yard. It's basically like a deathmatch map, or like an aim map, basically, in the train yard. It's just chaos all over the place, and it's quite favorable for the T's because, you know, you're pushing forwards. And as a CT's, it gets really difficult because if you lose a guy somewhere, all of a sudden, in an instant, maybe your position's bad now, and you're exposed from this other angle. But as a tease, you don't have to worry about this so much. You can just, you know, just keep moving forward, keep finding the headshots. And that's what they're very good at doing between, as you mentioned before, RPK, Scream, and Shox. So they found a lot. I think that they were just outfragging Godsent like crazy in this matchup, which was really fun to watch, at least.
Yeah, I think we can find out the thoughts of Mr. Murray, who is going to return for the last European match to give his thoughts. What do you think of all that madness?
Hey, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay, cool. Just making sure. Yeah, definitely a nice couple of games there. On the first map, Godsent really dominant, went on Overpass. On Train, G2 really just kind of tore open that second half. It was pretty close up until that point. So each team takes a map away from this matchup.
So what do you feel like were the deciding factors here for G2? I think Godsent and G2 have some similarities in the fact that I think individual skill really allows them to... They can build their gameplay off of that fact alone, and both teams seem to do it in different ways. So how do you feel this map worked out for G2? Because it was the pick of Godsent.
Yeah, I think there was just a certain point in the second half, those last few gun rounds, where you just saw G2 be able to abuse the outer bomb site with some pretty quick executes. Even someone like Shox, who usually lurks in the inner halls on this map, was kind of the first guy out outer. And you notice, like, I think of two of the last three gun rounds they won, Shox got the opening pick. Even though he didn't have a great KD ratio across the entire map, you would just see him be able to get an instant 5-on-4 for his team, which I thought had a substantial impact on the game. And then you had other guys like Body, particularly, played a really great CT side and inner, carried that over in the second half. Scream had a great game. So, yeah, the talent really did shine through for G2.
Awesome stuff. Dust will be joining us again later on for the North American matches. Thank you very much, Dust. That's going to bring the European segment to a close. So there'll be an hour's break before we start with North America. So make sure you're following the channel. And in the meantime, check out the James versus Dan video on YouTube if you haven't seen it already. But actually, we're going to go to the break with episode 3 of the matchmaking series. What kind of series going on here at Face It? We'll see you later.